So we're here at Hadley Railway Walk, where of course we've been before some time ago. Geocaching, it's been called a treasure hunt. Do you think there's the likelihood of finding any cash or stroke valuables in the next kind of 2 or 3 hours? Because that's really exciting me.
No, a rubber dinosaur maybe, a pencil eraser, something like that, maybe.
A classic one, a sellable one, a collectible one, one we could sell for lots of money?
No.
Gold that we could put in those special envelopes?
Nope. But we have to, whatever we take out of this box that's hidden somewhere that we have a couple of, what do you call it, longitude and latitude. What do you call that?
Is that coordinates? Map coordinates?
That's the fellow, yeah. Whatever we take out of this box that's hidden,
yeah,
we have to replace something in there.
I haven't got a great deal on me. I've got a handkerchief, half a packet of mints, and one of our almost legendary publicity postcards.
The one where you're cuddling me?
I'm not cuddling, it's a manly squeeze. Anyway, we can replace whatever we take with one of those, and whoever finds it next time will have a lot of fun.
Now, the clue, the cache is located by the old railway line between Hintlesham and Hadley in the heart of the Suffolk countryside. Starting from the Hintlesham car park, follow the track towards Hadley, and the cache is located just under half a mile of easy walking in a watertight clear plastic container, which is of a regular size. Now, what does that mean?
Well, regular, how long's a piece of string? One man's exactly. Regular, another man's huge.
I have with me.
Yeah? Many pockets. He's got one of his jacket of many pockets is what he's wearing at the moment.
I have this.
What is it?
This is a GPS unit.
Oh, right. I thought it was just an old school phone that you're using for retro reasons.
No, this is my bicycle GPS unit. Now, what I should say is we're both geeks. I mean, this is the perfect thing for us.
Yeah, it's technology. It's got LED display. It's even got its own lanyard.
I like you knew what that's called. Wow, yeah. Wow. You really are a geek.
I am a geek. If it's got a digital display and a lanyard, I'll have it, whatever it is.
This should be easy. This should be one of the easiest ones we've done.
It should be really easy. It says it's an easy walk and it's relatively easy to find. You'd have to be a pair of complete idiots to A, get lost, and B, not find it.
To A, get lost, and B, not find it. So off we go.
Trees on either side, nice shady walk, although it is clouding over a little bit here.
We love echoes, and we just come underneath this bridge.
Who can't resist going bah to make the most of the acoustic? You do it, it's great fun.
Bah.
No.
My voice doesn't echo. I think I'm like the devil or something.
you cast no shadow and your voice has no echo. Strange.
I think it's time to start programming the GPS unit. So it's a little GPS unit. Have you seen this before?
It's fantastic. I don't understand it.
Well, at the moment, it's picking up all the satellites that are up there. Because that's how GPS works, Simon.
Don't patronise me. Satellites?
Flying around in the sky.
Wow.
So hopefully, eventually, when it's finished acquiring satellites...
It's good to have all this technology at your fingertips, and there's a map's appearing. Is that us? Is that where we are?
That's where we are at this moment. No, I've never done this before. I've never inputted...
Well, now you say it.
A grid reference, because usually I use online mapping sources for my cycling needs and just follow a track. So this is where the fun begins for me and my geeky side.
I should have packed one of those silver foil survival blankets. Why do you want to keep recording this?
I might get some golden moments.
You might get some golden moments.
I'd stop recording for a little while. Simon's been waiting patiently for the last 10 minutes.
And the rest. I've had a snooze, I've had a look around.
Southeast to Geo.
Which means... What?
We've got to go... Hang on.
Oh, we got to scramble up a bank.
Well, no. So by the side of the bridge that we went under, which Simon did all the... Bah. There's a kind of a little path up the side of it. Don't know if it's an official path.
No, but there are many feet of worn sort of steps up here. So let's...
So scramble up?
Let's scramble up.
Oh, hang on, there's someone... down there. I'm not going to talk to them. Can I talk to you quickly? Okay, well, my name's Matt. That's Simon. We do a show on a Sunday afternoon. Right. Geocaching. Have you heard of geocaching?
I have, yes.
Do you ever do it?
No.
Oh. Would you be tempted to do it?
No. I just enjoy walking.
You just enjoy walking?
Yes.
Where are you going today?
I'm going to Ipswich.
So you've got about another 8 miles?
Something like that.
Where did you start?
I started in Hadley and I'm off to Tesco's for a bit of lunch.
Really?
Yes.
And then...
My
walk
wife
home?
Will do the shopping and she'll bring me home. Yes.
Excellent. Good way of doing it. So, do you enjoy the Suffolk countryside?
Oh, it's wonderful, isn't it? Yeah. Yes.
A short walk for you or a long walk? Or
It's a relatively short walk for me, yes. I've just done the coast to coast in England from Wainwright's Walk. So that's about 200 miles. So That was a good walk, yeah.
That's been on television recently with Julia Bradbury, is her name?
Julia Bradbury, yes. Okay. Yes, all along the walk people were talking about Julia Bradbury and where she'd been and...
So she's responsible for a lot of walking this year?
I think so, and I think they say next year it'll be a hugely popular walk. The bed and breakfasts are already being fully booked.
Tell us where to look, maybe. Could you just point us in a direction and we'll look in that direction for the geocache that we're searching for? Because we think we're close to it at the moment.
Oh, I see. Right. Well, what about under that pile of logs? Because that looks like it might be a good spot. It will be hidden somewhere, won't it?
Okay, well, we'll have a look under that pile of logs. What's your name?
Jim.
Thanks, Jim. Cheers.
So we're now, I suppose, not exactly off the beaten track, but we're on another smaller track, aren't we?
Yes, just going through some woods. What kind of
deciduous trees?
That's it.
So I know what he's going to say, because he often stutters the first three letters. To my right, there's another pile of sticks. These aren't logs. These are sticks bordering the pathway.
A lot of it depends now on my programming of the GPS unit. Did I put the right coordinates in?
Okay.
A few coordinates off, that would lead you...
A merry dance.
Yeah. Yes, this is a nice activity because we're out here. We wouldn't have come here and found this place unless we're doing this geocaching.
Exactly, and because you have to have a reason sometimes to go to places that you wouldn't just go to them, and this is great.
Good morning.
Morning.
You look you don't look like a traditional walker.
I do walk regularly.
So where are you heading to?
I'm going to the end, and
yes.
I'll sit there for 5 minutes, and then I'll walk back to Hadley, which makes a 5 mile walk.
Oh, right, so it's just a Saturday afternoon.
We walk regularly, my wife and I. She's not with me now, but we love walking, and it's beautiful here.
Yeah, it is beautiful, isn't it?
It's peaceful, you've got cornfields to the right.
We're geocaching today, which is...
What does that mean,
geocaching? Looking for treasure. People leave little tubs with little toys in or something, and we can go and try and find them. It's a popular activity.
Is this a spoof?
No. Usually that's the kind of thing we do. We do go to that kind of stuff, but this is perfectly serious today.
This is genuine. According to our calculations, yeah. Up this bank and the tree stump is this container, which you can find, you can take something out of, and you can leave something in.
Mate.
So we're going to see if we can find it and leave one of our publicity postcards in there, and then somebody else will find it.
Who in heaven's name is going to go through there looking for a BBC Radio Suffolk?
You'd be surprised.
You'd be surprised.
Wouldn't that be touching on the bizarre?
Well, wouldn't you go through brambles to see this image?
Oh, very good.
There you go.
Well, that's a BBC photo taken in the studio.
Yep, that's us. So yes, that's somebody's prize for scrambling up there.
Very good. Well, this is only the second time I've ever been on radio. No, it was television last time. This was many, many years
ago. This is the first time?
This is the first time on radio. It was television, it was Sky or BBC, I can't remember. I had my 15 seconds of fame.
Another couple of seconds for you.
Well, indeed, yes. Well, it kills a bit of time, doesn't it, for you chaps?
Matt's busy studying his GPS unit. I know we're in the right zone, it's the right area. It's just fine detail of finding.
I'm beginning to find it frustrating and annoying, and I can't see any pleasure to be gained from this activity.
See, it's normally me that loses the will to live. I'm quite excited about this. I want to find it. I don't want it to beat me.
You're standing in that stance again.
I can't help standing. This is a great start. If there's logs on the floor and you like stances, left leg on the log, bent, left arm on your knee, and my goodness, but you look outdoorsy, and a little bit like Peter Pan.
Oh, hang on.
What?
Well, I'm just...
What? I heard a noise.
I got it.
Oh, well done.
It's not in a tree stump.
We can say that much. Oh, excellent. And it is, it's a sealable plastic container with the official geocache sticker on it. We think we might need to take a photograph of this.
So this is right, so there should be lots of objects in here. The original person would have put some objects in. And then yep. Every time someone comes along, they replace an item and take an item. Now what's it say?
It says, official geocache, please do not disturb. This is an official game piece. Refer to geocaching.com for details, which we advise you to do. Hadley Express, the name of the thing, we found it.
So in here, there's a log book.
Here we go, the last person who found this.
19th of July? No, that's...
8th of the 8th, 09. We've got a wide selection of things here. Piece of paper, a horse, a medal, a yo-yo, a leaf, a penguin. What's that?
McDonald's toy. Handkerchiefs.
Some soft and strong tissues.
What's this?
You might find that useful, Matthew. Right. I've taken 1 cent piece out.
So to be clear on this, we have placed a Matt and Simon publicity photo in the Hadley Express geocache box. There we go.
Now we'll just replace that.
So now we need to hide it.
Did I put it in the right place?
Now we need to cover it back up and make sure it looks undisturbed.
Complete.
Okay, so...
Yep, you can hide it though, because you're more one with the soil than I am.
So not an easy find. If you're an experienced geocacher, then
it's a
piece walk in the woods.
Piece of, oh, what a lovely way to end the piece with one of your famous puns.
A walk in the woods.
Yeah, it was good the first time, Matthew.
A walk in the woods.
Can't lose its effectiveness by the time you get to number 3.